Lacrosse Jack, I coughed so much, it's given me a six pack every time I cough. Hey guys, you're probably here because you wanted to know all about those collagen supplements. And do they actually work? Do they help with the hair? Do they help with your skin? And do they do all the claims that we're seeing these days? Well, I'm gonna answer that question, and I'm gonna answer many more in this week's Responding to Your Comments, where we look at fun questions, where we look at science questions, and most importantly, we use evidence to give you the best answer. Shari Barrera, I would like to see a video for women and thinning hair. Does collagen help? Shari, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Get Rid of Dandruff video. Collagen, it's a big trend at the moment, isn't it? It's everywhere. And collagen itself is everywhere. It's a protein which is everywhere in our body. And one thing that it's responsible for is it allows for that elasticity in the skin. Now, as we age, our bodies produce less collagen, okay? And a lot of these companies who manufacture collagen supplements are really capitalizing on this fact that we need more collagen. And because of this, the global market for the collagen supplements is actually $4 billion. And many brands claim that collagen supplements help with things like your skin, your hair, your nails. And actually the evidence supporting ingested collagen, so swallowing collagen, is actually massively overblown, and there's actually no evidence supporting this. So let's look a little deeper into the evidence. Can a collagen supplement actually help with your hair, skin, and nails? Because in theory, we lose collagen as we age, so if you're replenishing your collagen, in theory it should help, right? So what needs to happen when you swallow a collagen supplement? Well, basically, your body will break it down, then it needs to absorb into your bloodstream, and then it needs to somehow travel to your hair, skin, and nails, okay? And here's the best part. Some collagen supplements actually claim that their product is fast absorbing, something along those lines that they put on. This is a fast absorbing collagen supplement. Great for you to use, something along those lines, okay? But here's the evidence. Collagen supplements have only been found to get as far as your bloodstream. They have not been found to get as far as your hair, they've not been found to get as far as your nails, and they've not been found to get as far as your skin. So what does this mean? This means that it's very unlikely that the collagen supplement is actually getting into your skin, is actually getting to where you want it to get to and building up those collagen stores there. However, saying all that, there have been some studies that have shown that collagen supplements can help with skin elasticity and moisture. But, and it's a big but, okay? As a healthcare professional, I look at studies all the time, okay? Now, I'm not gonna go through all the detailed stuff that I look through in a study to make sure how credible it is and looking at the results. But there's a few things that anybody can do when they look at a study. So for example, the first thing you can look at is how big was this study? Was it done on a handful of people, 5 or 10 people, or was it done on thousands of people, okay? A good study is a study that has been done on hundreds of thousands of people, not a handful of people, okay? Which is what these studies have been done on. The next question you can look at is how long was this study done for, okay? Was the study done for 5 to 10 years, which is a good length, okay? Or was it done for a couple of weeks or months, which is what these studies were done. They were done for a couple of months, okay? And lastly, which is the most important question you look at for any study, is who funded this study, okay? Was it funded by a big company, a research company, a university, whoever? Or was it funded by the actual manufacturers of the collagen supplement? And in these studies, they were funded by the collagen manufacturers or the brands who are trying to sell the stuff. Which makes you think, how reliable were these studies if they were funded by the companies who are trying to sell them? That's all I'm gonna say. Just think about it. How reliable is that study really? That was a really long answer, but I just wanted to give you all the information I had so you can make the right decision, because a lot of these companies are making a lot of false claims, which I don't know how they're getting away with. So I just want everyone to know the facts that are out there. And in the future, the collagen supplements, these collagen supplements really need more studies on them, okay? They need to be done for a longer duration, they need to be done more people to see if it's causing any side effects or problems mainly, and also to see if they work. It also needs to be funded correctly. And as a healthcare professional, I cannot recommend a collagen supplement to a patient because the evidence is just not there and it's not safe to do so. Which brings me on to another point about safety. A lot of these supplements, they're not regulated. So nobody knows what's in them properly. They're not regulated or tested to make sure that it is actually what they are claiming is on the box is in the actual pill. This is a massive problem that a lot of supplement companies have. And what I will do is I'll leave more information about this in the description below for you as well to please read up on. And I always tell my patients to please use things that there's evidence supporting it. So for example, let's say if someone wants to help protect their skin from aging, okay? Make sure that you're using a sunscreen, because we know that sun damage causes the most damage to the skin in aging. So you need to be using the correct sunscreen with the correct SPF, with the correct UVA protection. And I did make a video about this not long ago. I will leave a link up here and in the description below for you as well if you want to find out more information about sunscreens. And also, for example, when it comes to aging the skin as well, if we're staying on that topic, you need to make sure you're not over-exfoliating. A lot of people exfoliate their skin every single day, and this is very harmful for the skin. You need to be exfoliating once or maximum twice a week. And also, eating your fruit, eating your vegetables, and if you smoke, you need to quit smoking, because that can also age the skin. Thank you for your comment, Shari. I hope this video has helped explain all about collagen supplements to you and to everyone who's watching this video. You all now know about the facts of collagen, if it works, the evidence, the safety, you know everything about collagen. You're a collagen supplement pro. So please tell your friends, tell your family, tell your loved ones, tell everyone, because you now know everything. Thank you for your question again, and now let's move on to the next comment. Lacrosse Jack, I've coughed so much, it's given me a six pack every time I cough. Lacrosse Jack, thank you for your comment. I was there not long ago. I went snowboarding a couple of weeks ago. I ended up pulling certain muscles in my abs that I probably never used. And I came back and I caught a cold and I had a bit of a cough. And every time I coughed, I was getting these pains in my abs. And then you commented and I saw this and I was like, oh, other people are having the same problem. So anyway, I'm much better now. I didn't get a six pack, unfortunately. I hope you're better also, but please remember, if your cough hasn't gone, if it hasn't improved, and you've watched my video and it's been more than 3 weeks now, or you have any medical conditions, which I explained in the video, please speak to your doctor or your healthcare professional. Thank you for your comment. Life Lover, thanks for the subtitles. Life Lover, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Grow Taller video. I picked this comment in particular because I wanted to discuss something with you all. For some strange reason, every now and then I get a comment, people asking for subtitles on the videos. So I just want to let everyone know now, every single video that I have on my channel has subtitles. They are 100% correct. The timings are all correct because Nadia, who's my editor, she puts the subtitles on every single video and I check them all as well, and they're always correct. So if you ever struggle to understand what I say, if you ever struggle to hear what I say, if my British accent is difficult for you to understand, if I'm speaking too fast, just click on the subtitles button. It's 100% correct. It's either the CC button if you're watching on a desktop, or if you're watching on your phone, you click the three button icon on the top right, I think, and then you click subtitles and it will pop up. Easy as that. Life Lover, thank you for your comment. Have a great day. Conchita W, I was always wondering to whom does the angry looking cat belong to? Does it have a special meaning? Conchita, thank you for your comment. I hope you're well. Conchita has always commented on every single video that I post. Conchita also really enjoys the bloopers, and so do I actually. I mean, the information's good, but the bloopers, they are really good sometimes. So, with regards to the cat, I'm not filming in that room today, but usually in the room that I film at, there is a little cat. It's a little toy cat, and I usually put it on the sofa behind me here, and it looks into the camera. I like it being there. It gives me good luck, I think. But with regards to that cat, I actually never knew why that cat was there, so I just used to put it there. But I've done some research, and in the practice that I work at, I spoke to the practice nurse, who's like the most senior nurse here. She's actually a sister, and she knows everything that goes on in the practice. So she told me that the cat is called Grumbles, and that cat has been there for a long time, because that's actually a meeting room where I film it. And what happens is when we have our meetings, if you ever have something that's really stressed you out and you really want to talk about it, you're meant to grab hold onto Grumbles, Grumble the cat, and I guess you're gonna have a bit of a grumble. So you're gonna be talking about it so then everyone can learn and reflect on it. So you hold Grumble the cat and you talk about it. And that is the story of Grumbles. I think I've said Grumbles too many times. Thank you for your comment. Have an awesome day, Conchita. It's me. I'm gonna become vegan from tomorrow. It's me. Thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Lose Belly Fat video. This is actually a really good idea for a video that I was thinking of. How about a challenge? Like Abraham the Pharmacist goes vegan for 30 days. It would be like a diary style video and I would document how I get on. Just throwing it out there to see what everyone thinks. If you think it's a good idea, leave a comment below. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know what you would like to be included in the video. And we could do this idea on many different topics. So vegan is one, going keto is another, and many different stuff. Thank you for your comment. I hope my tips in the video help. Have a great day. Looks like we've run out of time again in this week's responding to your comments. If I missed your comment, I'm really sorry. We are getting so many comments these days that it's very easy to miss them. So the best advice I can give you is leave it in the comment, and I'll try my best to get back to you in a future episode of responding to your comments. Always remember you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.